Hi everyone, myself Nimmi Abzal. Welcome to Adorable Life Photography. Are you a food blogger? Or are you someone who loves taking food photos? Then you are at the right place. I am here to help you with improving your food photography and styling. I am not a big professional in this field, but still I would love to share my experience and knowledge in food photography with you all. So let's get started. Today I'm going to show you how to take a light and airy food photo with action. I always start the shoot by setting the props without food in it. Then I do check the lighting, camera settings, etc. Most of the time I'll be doing this during the preparation of the food so that I can quickly start the shoot once the food is ready. Then after bringing the food, I do necessary changes in the position of the tripod as well. For this particular photo, I set the camera at 45 degrees. So let's check the settings that I have done for today's shoot. We are using natural light and light is coming from that window where in front of which I have kept a diffuser. We are using a white backdrop and on the side I have kept a reflector. Okay, so now let's check with the camera. Okay, so here in the camera, first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to switch on the remote control. Okay, so if you switch on the remote control option on, you can easily control the photos. Okay, so I'm just checking whether it is working or not. Okay, so yeah, it is working. Yes, so now we are ready to go. So here is the photo which I have taken with the current setting, that is shutter speed 1:4, aperture 4.5 and ISO 100. This setting is kind of ideal for taking a light and airy photo without any action. Later I felt like I should add some element to the photo other than the cup of tea. So I added an artificial plant. As it's an artificial plant, I didn't make it too visible by keeping the aperture low. So now let's make necessary changes in the camera settings in order to take a high speed action photo. So I kept the shutter speed 1:320, aperture 3 and then ISO 2000. Then I focused inside the cup. Okay, I tried clicking the photo with the remote. Okay, so it's working. So now let's do the action. First I tried to make the tea splash using a popsicle stick, which didn't work. Then I tried pouring the tea using a cup, that too didn't work. So I took a tiny milk pot to do the same, but still I was not getting the single drop tea splash as I wanted. So I removed the lemon slice from the teacup and tried again. Thankfully it worked. So all this time I was clicking using the remote. Okay, so I have no idea how the photos came so far. Now I went back to the camera in order to check all the clicks that we have done so far. Okay, so that I can make necessary changes in the camera settings. So when I checked the photos, it was not that satisfactory. So I changed the mode to low continuous and started clicking without the remote. With one hand I was dripping tea and with the other I was continuously clicking the camera. So after a few trials I again checked the photos and thankfully I got one perfect single drop splash. So now I'll tell you the camera settings in which I got it. I kept aperture 3, shutter speed 1:320 and ISO 3200. While capturing an action shot photo like this, we have to keep the shutter speed high, like more than 1:200. Then accordingly, we have to increase the light by keeping the ISO to a bigger number. In this particular photo, I kept the aperture to 3 because I don't want the element in the background to be highlighted much. So here is a raw image which I copied from the camera to my laptop. Do you want to know how I edited the photo from this to this? Then please do click the link of the next video showing how I edited this photo. If you liked the video, please do subscribe to my channel and like and share. Thank you so much for watching and stay tuned for more videos like this.